I'm Bob and I like to make stuff. Today we're gonna make action props. A lot of times when we do projects, it's to make a thing to fill a specific need, but sometimes it's about learning a new material or a new process, and that's the case today. We actually came across some really cool materials that we want to test out, and so to do that, we're going to make some action props. So I think today we're actually going to make three different things that include different types of mold making and different materials to cast inside those molds. The first one, and what really spawned this project, is something called Smash Plastic. This isn't sponsored by them or anything, but it's just a cool thing that we found and we want to try out. This is a two-part that you mix together and it makes a skim coat, a breakable plastic that you can put inside of a mold. And you end up with something that you can easily smash on somebody's head, but it's not sharp, it's not gonna hurt them. Imagine you're watching a movie and you see somebody break a bottle over somebody else's head. This is the stuff that they would use for that, so I wanna test it out, and we're gonna make our own bottles with it. Another thing we wanna try out is to take something that's hard and dangerous and actually make a soft, maybe bendable version of it. Imagine you had an action scene where somebody's swinging this thing around. You don't actually wanna get hit with a crowbar, but if this were made out of silicone rubber, it would be a lot safer. So we have the idea of taking this and putting an armature on the inside of it so it will hold its shape if it gets bent. That's gonna be an interesting mold to make, but the first one we're gonna start with is making a stunt concrete block. We're gonna start with this rough looking concrete block. We wanna make something that is much lighter, but still looks pretty much real. So to do that, we're gonna use an expanding foam. We need to make a mold of this out of silicone and then fill that mold up with this foam that expands to fill the space and is self-skinning, so it creates a skin on the outside that you can paint to make it look real. So the first step here is to make a mold box to hold this thing so that we can cover it in silicone. Now, the mold box I made for this is out of plywood, which is definitely overkill in most cases. You could use, you know, cardboard or something like that for most mold boxes. But eventually, we're gonna be putting silicone in here, and then once we take the block out, we're gonna be putting expanding foam in here. And when that expands, it's gonna be forcing the mold out, trying to fill all of the available space. So by having a more rigid outside, hopefully, it'll help give us a better final casting. I'm gonna go ahead and put this kind of where I want it, just leave it in place and then pour silicone around it, and we'll move on. Now that I've got this in here, I'm gonna fill some of this space because we definitely do not need to fill all of this with silicone. It would be a huge waste. So I've got a couple of pieces of 2x4 that we're gonna hot glue down to the bottom, and so they'll take up this space. Then when we go to fill this mold to make the cast, we'll put these back in place just to keep that area filled up. We've got the concrete block in here, and I've been thinking about exactly how to pour it, how to get it out of the mold once it's poured, and which silicone to use. We actually just did a bits video on different types of silicone, so you should definitely check that out. For this one, I think we're gonna go with a plat 40. Now, this is gonna be pretty rigid once it gets in here, but when we go to take the block out, we can actually cut the silicone to make it easier to pull out of here, and then since it's going back in this rigid box, theoretically, the silicone should go back together for when we make the cast. So I'm gonna go ahead and mix up a few small batches of this because I need a lot of it. So I'm gonna have to do a small batch at a time, pour it in, then do another small batch. And while I'm making the silicone for the block, Josh is gonna move on to making molds for the bottles. We're actually gonna use a PVC pipe and put it down around the bottle on a piece of wood and hot glue it in place. That way we can pour silicone on top of it to make the mold. Then when it's all cured, we can just kind of pop it off the piece of wood and we'll have a mold around a bottle. Now that we've done a couple of different types of molds, the next one we're gonna do is actually a two-part mold. This is something I've never done before, so I'm pretty excited, but a little bit nervous to try it out. This is gonna be made out of silicone with an armature wire running down the center of it so that it will hold its shape unless I wanna bend it, okay? So the idea here is that you put down a layer of clay inside of a mold box, you stuff this down about halfway, and then you pour silicone on top of it. After that cures, you flip it over and add silicone to the other side, so you've got two mating pieces. So the first step here is to make a box that can hold this and have a removable top and a bottom so that we can make those two different parts. So the first thing here is to add a layer of clay along the bottom, and you want to make sure that the clay does not have sulfur in it because the sulfur will stop the silicone from setting up all the way. I used the end of some of these tools to make some little indentations down in there, and the silicone's gonna go fill that. So then when we flip it over, we're gonna have a negative and a positive that can mate together so that the two pieces of the mold will go together when we go to cast it. Now we have to wait for the first half of that mold to cure up. So we're gonna demold the big block that we did yesterday. I made sure to put letters on each one of these corners so that we can put the box back together in the same position so that when we go to pour this, we've got a box to back the mold. I honestly do not know if this is gonna work. I kinda have a feeling we're gonna have to cut this up a lot to get the block out of it, but let's find out. So definitely leaked a little bit under, which kind of figured would happen. The good thing is this is gonna be the top of the mold, and so it doesn't matter really what this face looks like because the expansion foam is gonna come up and we're gonna trim it off at this point, however it comes out of the mold.
Hello.
Now that we've got the sides kind of pulled away, we're gonna have to cut the corners to be able to actually get the block out of here. The center part is still gonna be really difficult. We're gonna start by making a wavy cut down here on the corners so that those two pieces can fit back together really well once we put it back in the box. Thank you. got the sides cut away, and I think we're gonna have a lot of trouble getting these center sections out, and luckily, concrete blocks are really inexpensive, so I think we're gonna take a sledge and break this away, and that'll give us the center sections here that we can leave the wood intact to keep their structure, and we can put the whole thing back in the box. Now that we're going through this, it is coming off, but it's gonna be a lot of work to get all the small pieces off here. We didn't really have a good way to mold release the block itself, so I think coming up with a way to cover it in something, just to make it a little bit easier to pull away from the silicone would have been good. And instead of doing solid blocks here in the middle, I feel like these should have been just boxes that were empty on the inside so that they could compress and we could more easily get this section out of the middle of the block. Now we've got the mold ready. It's got some mold release on it. We're ready to jump in and actually try to put this foam inside of it. This is from Alumilite. It's flexible foam. Never used it before. It looks to be kind of exciting, but we realize that we actually don't have enough to fill this entire mold. So we're gonna mix up what we have, pour it in there, and kind of see how far it goes. The big thing about this is that the reaction happens really quickly. You don't have a lot of time. So we're gonna tint one side of it before we mix the two pieces together and pour it in. All right, here we go. Go.
1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, 4 Mississippi, 5 Mississippi, 6 Mississippi, 7 Mississippi, 8 Mississippi, 9 Mississippi, 10 Mississippi, 11 Mississippi, 12 Mississippi, 13 Mississippi.
Ew.
There we go.
All right, let's pull this thing out and see if it worked. So we may have to actually cut it out just to get it out, but we don't really need the mold anymore. So if we did ruin the mold, not a big deal.
Thing from, hey, from this angle,
that's cinder block.
That is a cinder block.
That is insane.
That was a huge amount of work, but it looks awesome. The tent that we put in it actually looks like concrete to me. Obviously the backside that was exposed, we need to trim off to make it flat, and that's gonna look a little bit different, but for our purposes, this is awesome.
Too much.
Now. So the concrete block turned out great. Now we're gonna move on to the bottles. Now we've got this silicone all cured up and we need to get it out of these mold jackets. And so we're gonna take this to the table saw and actually cut through both sides of the PVC so we can separate it, then cut down inside the silicone to get the bottle out. We've got the bottles taken out of the molds and the molds turned out fantastic. When you open them up, we've got them cut well enough that we can completely spread it out, because the bottles that we're gonna take out of here are gonna be really fragile on purpose. So this thing is ready to put in the smash plastic, like I mentioned before, but we need to heat these molds up because that makes the reaction take less time. These have been in the mold for a while, so we're gonna take them out, and I'm honestly not sure if we put enough material in them to see if they're gonna work, so let's just give it a shot. Nope. Okay, so this one is definitely too thin. The wall is too thin. You can see that what the material is like. So it looks like glass. Shatters really easily, but the wall was just too thin for this one, so. Hopefully one of the other ones we made will work out a little bit better. This one looks good. It might work. Ooh, look at that. All right, here, see if you can pull it out without, I don't want to mess with it. Like, try to. I got the clay pulled out of this mold, so now we're ready to pour the second half of this two-part mold. Again, this is something I've never done before, but I think we're all set up to be able to do it. I'm gonna mix some 20T. It only has about a 30-minute cure time, so we should be able to move ahead pretty quickly with this. Before we pour this in here, we need to add tons of mold release, because we're pouring silicone onto silicone, and if there's nothing in between those, they're gonna stick together, and then we will have an encased crowbar from now on. We're also gonna be mixing in these containers, which you shouldn't ever do, but we're actually running out of buckets to mix stuff in. These are the same amount, and we need to have a one-to-one mixture, so I'm gonna dump one into the other, and we're just gonna go with it. Both pieces of silicone are cured now, so I can take this out of the mold, and I realized last night that I did not put a pour spout into this, so we're gonna have to cut something in the top of both of these pieces so we can pour in the material to cast it. Also, I'm probably gonna have to destroy this outer jacket just to get these two pieces apart, so I may have to remake it or maybe just tape it back together when we go to pour. Now that we've got this mold ready to go, we're gonna be pouring in some urethane rubber inside of it. So this is gonna be flexible, but also gonna have a nice surface. It's not gonna be squishy like silicone would be. And inside that, we're gonna make an armature out of this wire. This is just something I got at the hardware store. But if you double this up and you twist it together, it becomes pretty rigid enough that it will hold its shape when it's bent. So we're gonna make a big piece that will follow down the center line of this and get it embedded inside the rubber. I'm gonna go ahead and try to make this mold go back together, the mold jacket go back together, so that when we actually put it together for the final pour, all of the different parts of this are supported. We don't want that to dangle or hang in any way. Now it's time to try to cast this crowbar. We're gonna do a bunch of things here I've never done before. We're using flexible urethane rubber, and I've never used that. It has a really short working time, so hopefully that will go well, but we've also never done cold casting. This is where you take some powder and you dust the inside of the mold and it ends up on the outside of your casting. And in this case, it's gonna make it easier to make this object look black so we don't have to dye the rubber before we pour it in. We do have a big air bubble here at the top. Hopefully we can pack some clay in there just to make that work for what we would use this for. But overall, the cold casting looks awesome. It totally looks metal, which is great. So we're gonna have some flashing we'll have to cut off once we get it out of the mold. Overall, this thing came out really well. This is a problem at the top, but we probably could fix that or just kind of shoot around it. If you were making an action scene, you know, you could hold it in different ways to kind of ignore that part. The other problem here is the flashing. I didn't get the mold put back together tightly enough, so there was a lot of flashing that came out in between the two parts of the molds, and I had to cut that away. Now, the problem with that is that you can see that area where I cut it away because it doesn't have the powder on it. But in the areas where the powder is on the surface, it totally looks like a solid piece of black metal. But overall, this turned out as a fantastic first attempt at two-part mold making and cold casting. We did a few different bottles and some worked better than others, but I want to take these outside and actually try them out to see what they look like when they smash.
Nice.
We learned a whole lot about different types of molding and casting in this video. Like I was saying, I hope this gave you some ideas of things that you can make for your short film or just for fun. Molding and casting can give you lots of really awesome things that you can make for all different purposes. We've got tons of other projects that you may want to check out, and if you're not subscribed, be sure to do that as well. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.